Oh, let's just do it. Oh man.
Looking like a little queen on a Monday night. Any Queen fans out there?
Who saw Bohemian Rhapsody recently? Great. Great. Oh, you just gotta give it a few verses too. We're gonna get into some things tonight. We're gonna get into some stuff.
Happy Monday!
Thanksgiving week. Me too. Yep. You want it all right now. Dude, Show Choir Day is coming out. Oh, man.
Hi.
All right, guys.
What's up?
How's it going?
Hi.
Happy Monday.
Happy, if you're in the States, Thanksgiving week. The week where we give many thanks to all of the things that we are grateful for.
We got to get a slight closer together here.
This is too close. Adam, I stink. I just got
no,
to the gym
don't.
Not too long ago. So,
well, you know what? This is always kind of a cool week for me. And anytime that we're in Thanksgiving week, one of my favorite parts about it, you know what? This is kind of silly. We got to get in the camera frame.
I'm going to turn off the TV.
Don't turn off the TV. No. There's high school state championship football being played right now. And I'm just going to kind of watch it in the background. Okay, fine.
Yeah.
Ah.
It's great.
It's already Tuesday there.
All right, guys. I just want to make – it sounds like we're coming in loud and clear. So in the event we're not, I have a laptop up as well. So I'll also work on chat if I need to. But if folks can look out in the chat, just logistics. In the event somebody loses sound and it's not trending, like not everybody doesn't lose sound because it's technology. Sometimes it has a little hiccup. So yeah, if you can't hear us or see us, just try refreshing. But everything's coming in all right on my computer, so I think we're in good shape.
Good, good.
So this week we got something new for you guys. If you're brand new to this webinar, we are Adam and Ashleigh Reeker. We are 30 and 31 years old. No,
man.
I'm 31.
Ooh, we're both 31 right now for like another 3 weeks, and then I'm going to be 32, which is stupid.
That's not stupid. It's wonderful.
I legit still feel like I'm 18.
Yeah, it's after 25. It's like I just lost track.
Well, I'm not trying to challenge anybody to a race or a marathon. I'm just saying mentally, I still feel 18. Physically, I feel, I don't know, 23. Like after you got done playing sports and stuff and you took like a year and a half off. That's me physically, but mentally I'm sharp as a tack.
You are sharp as a tack. So anyway, that's who we are.
Donald Leith and Stan Simmons have underwear older than us. I believe you both.
Little context for those of you who don't know, because there are some new people in the webinar. First of all, if you're new, we would just want to welcome you. You are in the right spot. You can check out a webinar every night, Monday through Thursday, Monday and Tuesday nights at 8 o'clock Central Time, and Wednesdays and Thursdays at 7 o'clock.
Truth.
With some of the leaders in Now Lifestyle, which is super duper awesome. We are blessed and honored to be a part of that group. We have been with this company for...
This is our... Okay, let's think about it. March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November. Our ninth full month.
We celebrated Valentine's Day this year on a webinar with Daniel Kump, who is our coach, as we were getting our business set up. I love you so much.
Will someone tell Jerry to refresh his page?
That would be awesome.
All right.
Anyway, so yeah, you can check out these webinars. And typically, we have been doing, our past messages have been around duplication and what it is and how it can completely help you just explode your business growth. But tonight we're gonna shift it up a little bit. We're gonna change it up a little bit, and we are going to bring you some mindset. We're gonna help you get this right. We are going to hopefully inspire you and just bring you a message of hope and just allow for you to pull in or pull out that motivation from within, because motivation comes from you, inspiration comes from others, and that's what we're here for. So,
man, I think most people miss what you just said.
That motivation comes from within. Only you can motivate you. Yeah. You can be inspired by others, but you can only motivate yourself.
A lot of people don't understand that. Yes, and I mean, you just said it all, but it is impossible for us to sit here in our, like, we have like an open concept home, so we're actually sitting in the kitchen. This is our living room back here.
We also broke our cardinal rule. We put up our Christmas tree.
Shh, we'll get to that.
Thanksgiving.
I cannot motivate you. I cannot motivate you. And the God's honest truth is I don't want to. And inspiration doesn't come from, you know what's stupid?
What?
People always talk about motivational speeches that change their life. There's not a single motivational speech that changed your life. You may have heard an inspirational story, but you motivated yourself. Motivation comes from within. I cannot motivate you. I can tell stories and talk about some truths and some success principles. They can inspire you, but they're not going to motivate you. They will not make you send a broadcast email at 11 o'clock next Thursday night when you're tired and you don't feel like sending it. I had a booger there, sir. That's truth. And so one thing that we are committed to doing every Monday night is telling you guys the truth. And the truth is such a beautiful thing. The truth is very misunderstood. Also kind of aligns with that statement, the lies that the world's been telling you since the day you were born. There's a reason why there's a certain amount of people that are uber successful in life, and there's a reason that the masses are not. And honestly, you know, God's honest truth, see, people come from different backgrounds. People come from different backgrounds, different upbringings, different cities, all that stuff. I don't care about any of that crap, because the God's honest truth is, if you want to win, you have to figure out what you want to do. You have to decide what you're willing to do to get there. And then you got to just be willing to sometimes go through it. All right.
Sometimes you got to always be willing to go through it.
It's a daily thing.
God, let's be honest. And that's kind of why we love getting to do these Monday nights, because, and I always like to, we both like to speak to the brand newest person. And there are people that are on here that have been partnered with Now Lifestyle and growing their businesses for a while. And then there are other folks that might just be popping on for the first time. They're like, what is this about? Here's what is so cool. When you partner with this company, you become a business owner.
Yep.
You're not an employee. You're not an employee. And that requires a change in mindset, because so many people are programmed to think like an employee and act like an employee and go to your boss and say, what do I do next? And that is not this company. That's not any online company. You have to learn how to think for yourself and motivate yourself. And so what we aim to do all day, every day with the people that we work with, and, you know, in the hour that we get with you once a week.
We only get an hour a week with Now Lifestyle.
Mm-hmm, is to just work on this, work on your mind. And so that is where it all starts. And I remember early on, when we were first getting started in business, way back when, before we were online, we were in offline network marketing. And we would both get so antsy because they were always working on our minds. And we never were like, just tell us what to do. Like, just give me the meat and potatoes on what I need to do to grow my business. And honestly, that stuff's important, but that takes like, I don't know.
Set up your LCS and drive traffic. Plug into the team that you're associated with, and then plug in other people to what you just did.
It's that simple. You can go watch that in a video and learn how to do that. We teach it every week, multiple times a week.
It's the most boring thing. I sometimes fall asleep in the middle of a presentation. I'm like,
because it's not like that. That's going to get you so far. But business owner mentality and having a success mindset is going to take you further than you ever thought. Success mindset, truthfully, can I say? I'll just say it.
Well, yeah.
Success mindset took me from being a college dropout to where am I at today? wherever I'm at today.
29? I'm just still trying to flatter over her age. You should never stop flirting with your wife. I'm telling you.
It's true.
I've just been writing my own pickup lines for Ashley the last like.
Guys,
week.
He had some really great ones.
Yes, I did. So. I was knocking
them out.
All
right, sorry, we're getting off track. So
anyway,
let's lay it down tonight.
But Ashley's absolutely correct. I mean, what it took her from, and honestly, I think I can only tell our story for so long. Then I have to tell other people's story or just tell the truth. But Ashley was a college dropout. Her last job, and this is kind of crazy. She outgrew her last job. Someone's messaging me. She outgrew her last job. College dropout outgrows her last role. And people came searching for her. So what did she outgrow? She was a vice president of a multi-million dollar company. Everybody hear that? College dropout. Worked and learned from successful people in this industry. Her last job that they could not continue to pay her enough to do was as a vice president of a multi-million dollar company.
That was fun.
And you know what's really cool? When you go to Thanksgiving at our various family's house, and they no longer know what the heck to think of you. So they're just very quiet and awkward. And we're not awkward people, so I'll just start conversation.
I mean, we're pretty awkward, but...
Well, yeah, right. Like, if I just have an opportunity to sit down and just talk to somebody, I do it. Like, you saw me do it the other night.
Oh,
it was
yeah.
pretty fun,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's wonderful.
And the things that we talk about, whatever they want to talk about. But you learn how to relate to people. Just because you may feel like you may be on a different level than the people that you used to be on the same level with, doesn't mean you can't love them. It doesn't mean you can't communicate with them. It doesn't mean that you can't tell them some things that they've never thought of or heard of before. And that's the stuff that can happen when you have a dream, okay?
Mm.
Now, what we're going to get into tonight is so seriously awesome, and it's about dreams. Dreams are everything. But here's the thing is the word dream in this world that we live in has become so cliche that anybody can use the term or the word. I don't care what language. I don't care what country. I don't care where you're from. Dream... People don't understand what it means, but they take and use the word dream, and then they use it to their advantage, basically a lot of times for marketing purposes, okay? Like Disney used to do it way back then. Like all these companies, or you know, the NFL or anybody that's winning at a high level, sports teams are just famous for it, but silly. But they talk about dreams. Like, reach your dreams, I believe in you. You know, shoot for the stars, you can reach your dreams, reach your dreams, reach your dreams. You know the problem and the thing I hate about that is every time they talk about dreams, they talk about material things. Don't they?
Your dream being like a car.
Your dream being a car.
Or a home. Or money in the bank.
Yep.
I can sing a song for that, but I'm not going to.
Was it a good song?
No.
So you can't say it?
No.
Okay, well, Ashley can't sing her song about dreams this evening.
But dreams become possessing something, typically. Yep.
According to the world, yes.
Yeah.
Why? Because it's marketable.
Yeah.
So what I'm going to talk to you guys about tonight is the difference between a goal and a dream. Okay? And I'm gonna just kind of try to unbox this, unpackage this just a little bit at a time. And Ashley will chime in and probably knock it out of the park when I won't even see it coming because she's pretty awesome. But guys.
Ooh, Danny, sorry. Great question. We'll touch on that when we get to the end here.
Let's go full screen here because I don't want to be distracted during this time.
Cool beans.
This is maybe one of the most important talks that we've ever done. And you've seen us come on last week and we talked about Saturday night. Okay, and you've seen us come on the last weeks, and we were talking about closing out the year and the things that were really important for you to understand when closing out your year. And so to give you just be brutally honest with you, the reason you want to close out this year in a positive manner and know how to think properly is all about next year. Okay, so last Monday, I talked about Saturday night. Okay, you didn't hear me talk about a single material possession when I talked about Saturday night last week. And Saturday night's not even my dream, but Saturday night is coming. Okay. So you guys will have to go rewatch last week's webinar if you missed it. But here's the entire thing right now. We came on with the intro song called I Want It All and I Want It Now by Queen. Okay.
The infamous Queen.
Man, we saw Bohemian Rhapsody last week.
Great story.
Can I be honest with them? Ashleigh and I skipped out on work last Thursday. Number one, because we can. Wasn't always that way, but now we can if we want to.
Took the day off.
We went and saw Bohemian Rhapsody.
So good.
We played hooky.
It was so good.
But I thought about a lot of stuff there, and I just thought about that song, I Want It All. And everybody wants it all right now. Well, what is it that you want? Okay. And so as I unbox this, I want to kind of share with you a story that happened to me the very first month that I entered into this industry. So I was 19 years old. I actually was still enrolled in college at that time. And a lot of you guys know my story. If you don't, it's out there. You can find it or message me. I'll fill you in. I found network marketing offline when I was 19. 1 year to the day that my cancer doctor told me, hey, Adam, you're going to survive. You're going to live. So just go back to being normal. A funny thing for somebody to tell you when they just told you, 9 months earlier that, this is really pretty serious. We're in the weeds. I'm not going to tell you anything other than let's focus on treatment. But I got through it and I survived. Thank God. I had this thing happen to me. I started this industry and all of a sudden I started dreaming about what I wanted because this industry was so vastly different than anything my family taught me, anything that I had learned at college. And it's not, I'm not saying college is bad. College is just fine. They're just not going to teach you how to be wealthy. And so I started to learn that a lot of my, what I call dreams, they were goals. Like I wanted to have $10,000 in my bank account. Goal. Okay. I wanted to buy a brand new car.
Goal.
I wanted to go be the guy that could take any girl out that I met and drop like $500 on a meal. Why? Because I was 19 years old.
Also a goal.
Yeah. Never reached that goal. I was like 25 when I was able to do that with you.
In his time, not ours.
I always give her loud kisses. She hates
it. Really hurts.
Anyway, what happened the first month that I was in this industry, I was at the gym one night. And I had put a whole bunch of money, well, what I considered a whole bunch of money as a few hundred bucks, into the business that I had just started. And I was at the gym, and I come from a small town where like people don't mess with other people's cars. And I moved to Omaha, and there's a couple million or maybe like a million people, but much bigger than where I came from. And I was at a 24-hour fitness. I didn't think anything about it. I just left my wallet in the car. And I was really proud of myself that day because I was a server at a restaurant. And I had made enough money to pay my rent with cash and all my overhead bills, like everything, for the next month, all the while starting my own business, okay, in this industry. So I just left my wallet in the car, went in there and got a really good pump. Really good. Everybody knows if you're a weightlifter, you got a good pump on it. I was swole when I walked out of that place. And so I got out of there, got in my car, turned on my, started it, was pulling away, and opened my glove box. And my wallet was missing. And I was like, no big deal. Drove home. I was like, I'll just turn on my lights, my car, and we'll find it. I just must not have thrown it in the center console or whatever. Got home, could not find it. And searched my car, like high and low. I started to frantically search it. And it came to a conclusion like 45 minutes later. And I realized that I did not lock my car up when I went into the gym. And someone robbed me. Came in, took my money. I didn't have any money in my bank account. I just had cash because that's what I was going to pay my bills. I was going to go put it in my bank account so I could pay my bills, with a check or whatever. But it's gone. It's just gone. And I, for the first time in my life, got robbed. Like robbed, stolen, taken from. And it was one of the most impactful moments in my life. Really early on, because I was roommates with my brother. He was a law student on a full ride scholarship to Creighton University, which is pretty prestigious. I was barely hanging on at University of Nebraska because I still had some PE classes left to take. I hated college. I couldn't give him his rent money. And I came in there and I was like, man, I think somebody just robbed me. They just stole. And he made this wise ass comment to me. He's like, well, you started a business, you should be fine. And I wasn't. I couldn't pay my rent the next day. And everything was just going to be really super smooth and super easy. Just started a business, had my next month's bills paid. And somebody stole it from me. Somebody stole it from me. And it was so empty. And so what I could have done at that moment in time was went and got a refund from the business that I just started so that I could at least pay my rent. And I didn't. I did not. I said, hey, man, I'm going to go pick up some extra serving shifts. I'm going to go ahead and skip some classes here because, by the way, I'm paying for those and they're not paying me. And he didn't get that at all. He's like, oh, you're doing this thing so wrong. You're doing this thing so backwards. Like, cool, man. Don't got nothing else to talk to you about tonight. And I'm glad that happened to me. Okay. Because here's what happens in your life. By the way, if you're going through adversity right now in your life, I'm glad it's happening to you. I know that might sound really harsh. If you're going through adversity, I'm glad it's happening to you. Okay. Because adversity is a dream maker, not a dream taker. Okay. And at 19 years old, I had adversity hit me. And it made my dream. It didn't take it from me. I said, man, how stupid is this? I don't have enough cash on me to go pay my rent and my next month's bills because someone just stole from me. Adversity is a dream maker, not a dream taker. If you're going through adversity, it's making you, not breaking you. You just got to keep going. You got to make the right decisions. So I'm going to talk about getting robbed tonight. Okay. And everybody, when they're starting a business for the first time, they have these big goals, these big dreams, or so they think. Most times when you're starting a business, you just want to be able to pay your bills. You just want to be able to go buy that car. You just Ashleigh doesn't like when I do this sometimes, but you just want to go be able to do this for your wife. Okay. And you just want to have stuff.
Stuff.
Stuff is not a dream. Stuff is a goal. Okay.
Sometimes stuff is just stuff.
If you are going after something that is just about you, it's not a dream. It's not a dream. Okay. If it's about you, it's a goal. When you use the word dream, it's always about other people's lives. Mm. And that's just the way it is. Okay. And so you can rob yourself of your dream if you think a goal is your dream. Now, I want everybody to think about this. Think about something probably a lot of people have been stolen from in their life. Okay? There's two things I want you to think about throughout this entire talk. I want you to think about what you believe your dream is. And if as we go on and talk here, I want you to write it down. If as we're talking, you might have something else that pops into your heart or your mind that may pertain to what your dream is, write it down. But at the same time, I want you to think about what it feels like to get robbed. What it feels like for somebody to take something of yours that you worked hard for that didn't belong to them, but there's nothing you can do about it. Okay. Yeah, I know about anger.
You just feel helpless.
Yeah. Well, it's true. And so when every time you think about a goal and you try to convince yourself that it's a dream, you actually rob yourself of that dream. So think about it. When you think about your dream, what does it do to your body language? What does it do to your heart? What does it do? How do you feel about it when you actually think about a dream you want to accomplish? And then think about getting robbed and what that feels like. And every time you think that a goal is your dream, you're robbing yourself of your dream. Okay? There's a Christmas tree behind us right now. And if you guys were at the Now Lifestyle National Convention, which a lot of you probably weren't, I told the story about when this thing really happened for me, because it happened in me. And there was one year where I actually stole a Christmas tree because I didn't have any money left. Okay. And this will be a much deeper talk in the future, because I know I understand talking about someone stealing from me and I stole from someone. You know, I look at that Christmas tree back there. It speaks like a bazillion words. That was not my dream. It was just a goal. it was because I wanted to provide for my wife. It was because I wanted to provide for my family. Okay. This is really easy to get scatterbrained and all over the place. So I want you guys to remember, think about your dream and think about a time that you got robbed. Now understand, a goal is not a dream. A goal is something that is only about you or the people around you, you know, your immediate circle. A dream impacts other people. And I think at some point, everybody that builds a big team or a big business, they submit to the truth that it ain't about you. It's not about you. Because here's why. Everybody's always heard this old cliche again. If you help enough other people get what they want, you'll have what you want. I am here to tell you that's the God's honest truth.
So true.
We were able to pay our bills young. We were able to save some money. But we never, never were able to reach goals like living in our home or like I have 11-foot high ceilings with a 10-foot Christmas tree and like this cool like fireplace in the background, all this awesome stuff. You know why? Because I know a whole bunch of people on my team that just wanted to make a couple extra $100 a month, and I helped them do it. And if I hadn't, probably still living in a 500-square-foot apartment. Had to happen in me first. I had to understand the difference between a goal and a dream. And my dream is about impacting millions of people. And I had a webinar with a couple last night. Mm. And he told me what his why was. And his why had nothing to do with him and his wife.
It had everything to do with other people.
He's on a police force. He's a paramedic. He's a firefighter. He actually has PTSD from the traumatic things that he went through back then. And he said, you know what I learned about that? I want nothing to do with that. I just want to go help somebody. I want to go help somebody have a better life. I don't want to be the cop that's arresting them. I don't want to be the guy that scraped them off the road when they were driving drunk. I want to go help people. Okay? And so if you got a why or a dream like that, I told him flat out yesterday, I said, let's go. Okay? It's really important to understand that. Now, here's the thing that everybody misses. If you have a dream and you stay focused on your dream, all the stuff comes along with it. Everybody know Martin Luther King, I had a dream? Martin Luther King gave the speech, I had a dream. I have a dream. I have a dream. You know, when he gave that speech, he already had a house. He already had his wife. He already had his cars. He already had a stinking Nobel Peace Prize. And he's still talking about his dream. Let me just tell you, his dream was not about him. Okay? Does that make sense? Like, no, people, it's easy to miss this. I used to miss it. You know, the house, the cars, the, you know, the clothes, the food, the travel, the jewelry. That's just a ripple effect of you being focused on your dream. And if your dream is about other people, it's a real dream. If it's about stuff, you're just really good at reaching goals. And if you want to reach goals forever, I'll applaud you. I'll say, great job. Cool. Nice house. Beautiful car. Nice ring. Nice stuff. Who are you impacting, by the way? Who else is doing what you're doing? Because if I'm not willing to teach and help people do what they're doing, it's going to be pretty lonely. And I don't want to do it. That's the truth. I don't want to do it. And when I was so young, I screwed up so many times. I screwed up so many times until I realized that mistakes aren't bad. Mistakes are just you taking action before you understand it all, right? And then I had somebody tell me, like, hey, it's okay. We've made mistakes before. You can't make all the mistakes on your own, Adam, because I've already made more than you've made. And so now when I work with people and they mess up, I'm just so excited. I'm like, thank you. Cool. Go screw up. Go fall on your face. Go not understand anything about actually having a successful, fulfilled life. Cool. Because I don't want to make all the mistakes on my own either. So if you guys want to make them alongside me, I got your back. Let's just go make a whole bunch of mistakes together and then keep going. Right? Mm-hmm. All right. Cool. Anyways, that was my little bit of a rant segment, something I'm really passionate about.
That wasn't a rant. That was just some truth.
It was some truth for
sure. That was some mindset thrown at you.
So would you like to chime in and talk about you know, some of the things that are more important to you than just stuff, because, you know, really in the last year, all we want to do is come home and start a family and be able to impact people on a higher level than we've been able to.
Mm-hmm. I think you just said it right there.
Yeah, but I know, but I said it. They haven't heard you say it. When you say it, people really listen. They like perk up and they're like, oh, Ashleigh's talking. I'm taking notes.
Oh, that's cute. Yeah. I'm kind of at a loss right now because that was so good.
Sorry.
You guys, it's hard to follow this man sometimes. Sometimes I just sit here and I just listen to him because I could do that all day, every day. Yeah, so for me personally, for Adam and I, I don't want to get emotional. The dream for us has continued to expand. Like when we thought we had our dream, when we thought we had our why, the good Lord took it and just expanded it tenfold. And he was like,
hold on. Don't know anything.
Yeah, hold on, turn this corner because now I'm going to show you a larger picture. And then he turns us another corner and he's like, oh, but there's more to this landscape that you haven't seen. And it's been pretty powerful because for us, you know, when we got started with Now Lifestyle, truly, 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 we were just looking for a way out. We were just looking for a way that we could supplement our income that would allow for us to come home and be mom and dad, start our family. If that's what the Lord had planned for us, and I still believe he does, but he has now shown us something completely, like he took it and he like added like 10 exclamation points to the end of it in a way that we
just
never
taps me on the shoulder, whispers in my ear, and he's like, Adam, you don't know anything.
Yes. And you know, that's been unveiled to us through the amazing people that we've been able to work with and create relationships with. That are teaching us things that don't even realize that they're teaching us when they're communicating with us. You know, we both have things that we want to do in our lives, things that we both feel like we're called to do as individual, as a man and a woman. You know, I have things in my life and dreams that I have to inspire young women that are, you know, 18 to 25 who don't know who they are and get lied to by the world. But obviously I need a platform in order to do that. And, you know, what I think is so powerful is that by us reaching our goals, those goals tend to hold up the dreams that you're building them on. Because I know that if Adam and I don't reach goals, we don't necessarily have those, like we still have those dreams.
Have a platform.
Yeah, we don't have those dreams. We have those dreams, but a lot of times they're just a happy thought. And what are the things that we can do every day to hold those dreams up, to ensure that, you know, we're supporting them and that those dreams are beginning to come to fruition. And we've seen them. Like I could say today that we are living out a dream that we had when we were 19 and 20 years old.
Yeah.
But that dream was taken and it was expanded upon because
tenfold,
truly, you never really arrive. And if you feel like you do, you probably need to take a step back
and realize you're probably chasing goals and not dreams.
And really look at it and ask yourself, what am I fulfilled in this? Because a dream is truly going to fulfill you. It's going to, it's going to fill your heart. It's going to bring you joy. And for me, there's no greater joy in helping other people and seeing other people have those light bulb moments, even if it's something as simple as understanding their lead capture system or doing their first follow-up.
For real.
Yeah, doing their first follow-up. But what I love is when people begin to see their true potential, when they start to just break through that
light bulb moment
they thought they had. Yes.
So awesome.
And that for me is the best and is something that we're going to continue to live our lives doing. And, you know, Adam and I talk a lot about this with our team, is just being beacons of hope for other people, because this world sometimes feels hopeless. There are people that are giving up on themselves, physically, really deciding that they just don't want to be here anymore, or rolling over and giving up on their marriages or on their families. And those are things that, you know, we just really want to work to instill is that core family and helping people understand that you are more than what the world is telling you that you are. And that is just me kind of just shooting from the hip. But these are all things that, you know, when we sit up at night and talk about our dreams and our goals, those are the things that tend to come out. And I think that it's important that in your life that you verbalize those things, even if you're talking to yourself, even if you have you get a mirror out and you're talking to the mirror about the things that you want, to just start speaking them, to start saying the things that you want. Every morning I get up, I go into our spare bedroom. I have a mirror in there. I have a little floor pillow. I read my devotional. I do a prayer. I do some stretching, and then I do my daily affirmations. Yeah. And I speak the things that I want over my day. And I always say a message, like a few messages of gratitude, the things that I'm grateful for, but more than anything, what I want, so that I can remind myself if I'm having a hard day, if I get hit with adversity, whether it's at my job or during a workout, or, you know, I get rear-ended by somebody, I can remind myself why I do what I do, why I conduct myself the way I conduct myself. And it just keeps it right here. And that for me has been super helpful. So we didn't always speak like this. Like, we learned very early on from
no, mentors. I just wanted to be able to pay my rent my first month in business, and someone jacked my money for my car. And now here we are 12 years later. Sounds a little different.
Yep. And sometimes it's funny, we're still disgusted with where we're at, because we just know that we're capable of so much more in our lives and impacting other people. Yeah, and that's why, that's a little bit of our why. But I say that because none of the things that I just talked about have anything to do with material stuff.
No.
Like, this is all great, but Adam and I could literally, we talk about this all the time, we could go back to living in 550 square feet.
I guarantee it.
So happy.
I guarantee it.
Less to
I didn't have to mow a yard.
Anyway.
I'm so serious.
So,
guys, here's the thing that, you know, our story started somewhere. Your story starts somewhere or already has started somewhere. People's stories, they're made early in life, truthfully.
Mm.
It's probably the family that you were raised in, whether it was positive, negative, or otherwise, that is where your story starts. That's where your building blocks of who you're going to become as a person, that's where it all stems from.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so people's stories are made early in life. They can't be changed, but they can be changed. Okay. People's stories start early in life. They can't be changed, but they can be changed. I'll leave that for your own interpretation, okay? Everything that we do is on purpose, for a purpose. Always keeping the important thing, because we know that we know that we know that the important thing is our purpose. Was that a riddle or was that a statement? That's up to you to decide. Both of the last two statements that I just made, okay? Dreams are special. Everybody's got them. Most people don't even understand what a dream is because they watch the Hallmark Channel and they talk about a Christmas wish or a Christmas dream, and then everything's perfect, except they don't tell you what happened the year after that silly movie was made by Hallmark. Because mm-hmm. Look, we have to understand what we are trying to do.
Mm-hmm.
What we're trying to do. Oh, okay. We could just start where everybody, our newest person's at. I'm trying to make some money, trying to pay my bills. Cool. That's what a job's for. You want to have a dream? It ain't about you. It's about other people. You're going to get everything you ever wanted from it? Yeah. Yeah. Yes, you will. If you want it. But I don't want to talk to you about your goals. I want to talk to you about your dreams. Because if you talk to me consistently about your dreams, I ain't worried about you getting anything. You're going to have all of them. But there's a difference. Okay? So, with that, we should just play some more Queen. You want to answer some questions? I didn't answer any questions last Monday.
We didn't answer any questions last Monday. You guys, we will spend the last, like, 5 minutes.
20 or 30 if you have them. Minutes.
So, I'm going to take this down, and I'm going to let us just do the thing. And if you guys have questions for us on this topic tonight, or questions in general about now lifestyle or about online business in general, we will take them. So the next 5 minutes, it's open if you want to chat it up. Hopefully some of you got some awesome value from this tonight. If you did, and you want to drop us an A for applause in the text, that would be legit, and we would very much appreciate it.
You don't have to do that. Hey guys, for real though, I mean, if you've got some questions regarding now lifestyle or some thought process, you know what, just shoot us straight. Obviously we kind of shoot you guys pretty straight.
I see the 3LE team representing on here tonight.
Pretty much how it goes. They're That's also the awesome. Fastest growing team in the company. I don't know if anybody knew that.
One of them for sure. Mistakes are not mistakes. They're learning experiences. I'm in to that for sure.
Seriously. I'm just glad I'm not the only guy that screws up like repeatedly. Mm. Do you earn any? Oh, Carmen, what's up? Do you earn anything if someone directs you buys guaranteed paid signups? Nope. If they purchase Facebook leads, you do get commission off that. But it's exciting if somebody is willing to invest in themselves and their business to get guaranteed paid signups, because that will ultimately, yes, it'll add to your cycle commissions at the end of the month. So you do kind of indirectly get compensated for that. Yes,
we love those guaranteed paid signups. Some of my favorite.
Never Ending Story, of course, Danny. That's a great movie.
Is that the one with a giant monster that?
It's a dog. I'd like to call it. Well, I don't know if it's a dog.
Is
or
it a dog?
I would like to call it a whatever.
It's pretty great.
And if you ever watched Family Guy, which I don't watch all that much anymore, but that dogs they always do that. They always have.
Oh yeah,
dog
they do. There. They do.
Not promoting that, by the way.
That's so true. Not promoting. Oh, Family Guy.
Not promoting that. Yeah.
No one has questions. We must have just really covered it tonight.
I think they're just, hopefully they're not confused. I apologize if you are.
Tomorrow night, well, if anybody has a question, seriously, feel free to, you have us for the next 3 minutes. Take advantage of these opportunities.
Carla's very confused.
No, that's not
what Well, she said the word. Carla, explain, please.
No, I think.
She's probably not.
No.
Just sounded funny when I said it. I think you're good.
Well, somebody's thinking of an awesome question to ask us because I'm waiting for someone to just stump us with something. Tomorrow night at 8:00 Central Time, same place, same
bat time, same bat channel.
You can find our personal coach and mentor, Daniel Kump. Guys earned over $150,000.
Like really quick. Like this is a new company, so everyone understands.
It's amazing. Donald Leith, great question. Status of the page builder.
Well, okay, go ahead. This is
you, for
go
those ahead. Of you who don't know, because it's context, right?
Yeah.
For everyone, for folks that are new, there is a page builder similar to a ClickFunnels. ClickFunnels is a full-blown funnel builder. However, now Lifestyle is going to have a page builder that allows for you to create your own lead capture pages. You guys, it's a game changer because you can brand yourself. You can put your own photos. You could shoot your own video and put it on there. You don't have to create. You don't have to pay for an extra ClickFunnels account. It is still in beta testing. Joel has been with his team, his development team overseas. We are expecting an update here probably before Thanksgiving, if not at the end of the week, as to kind of what's going on. There are some folks that are beta testing it, providing feedback, which has been super helpful. We have been in it a little bit so far. It's been great. You know, like anything new, you've got to learn it. So we've had a little bit of a learning curve, but we're excited for it. And I do want to note that if anyone here has a VIP membership, so you're paying $9.99 a month, you will not have access to the page builder when it launches.
Yeah.
Anyone at the platinum pack who's purchased a platinum package, $50 a month, will have access to it. You can make as many pages as you want. You can share pages out. It's going to be
okay.
Awesome.
So how cool is this? If you guys have been out there and you've had an autoresponder that you've purchased in the past from various outlets, I don't even know.
AWeber, GetResponse.
Okay, Ashley's going to name them. Constantly. Or Conference Center Software or a Page Builder from ClickFunnels. You're talking like seriously $250, $300 a month.
We priced it out. It's about $300 for all those things.
And they don't even teach you how to use any of them. With Now Lifestyle, you get all of them under one $50 a month package. Give me a break.
It's insane value.
How powerful is your business? How powerful did it just become? Because so many people online and offline are looking for those three tools. You just get to be the person I introduce them and say, hey, I got access to all three of them if you're interested under one package. Mm-hmm. And whether they necessarily build Now Lifestyle or not, they have a downline in a matrix where they can pull residual income.
Yeah.
Now, how much more powerful did your business just become because you just heard that? It's not even fair, guys. This company is not even fair. and the world doesn't even know about it yet. So if you got a dream and you want to help people, you're in the right place, man.
For sure. Danny asked if we could send her the link for the platinum package.
Oh, you
Danny,
can upgrade.
Yeah. Or just open, you can upgrade from your back office. If you click on, I actually think if you try to click on one of the things that you don't have access to,
you have it. Yes. You can upgrade from your back office. We went all in Now Lifestyle the first day. And I apologize. That's just what we did. So literally I've never seen someone's back office if you're at the VIP level. But you have a timer up there where I think you could probably upgrade. Or if you click on a tool that you do not have, you can upgrade. You want to be at the Platinum membership. It's so well worth it, guys. And because you also get compensated with full binary cycle commissions. So it opens up the pay plan too.
Yeah. It's pretty awesome. I was going to see if I could find this. Actually, you know what?
I don't know if I would put this.
This is not our link.
Oh, okay.
So to Danny and Jolene, I'm going to put this link. We don't normally post links, but this is a generic link. So if you're logged, I want to just clarify, if you're logged in as yourself,
you need to be logged into your Now Lifestyle account when you click the link she's going to post.
And you click this link, you can upgrade. And that just to ensure that that credit will go to your personal coaching sponsor. So we're not dropping our personal links. We don't ever do that. I just dropped it. It's under Ashleigh. You can literally copy that, paste it. Danny, if you want to save it for Friday, save it for Friday, and you can go ahead and go in and upgrade. So, and Sanju, you as well. Guys, you're all making the right decision on that.
For sure.
Yeah, $50 a month is like...
It's a steal.
Oh, boy.
Honestly, I've when Joel told me about what was all going into the $50 package, it was like, wow, are you Santa Claus?
And VIP is great, but it's like you're just dipping your toe in. Like, it's kind of like you can earn $5 commissions, but honestly, it's like just get your feet wet. But, man, when you're ready to make it happen, Platinum's where it's at. And then when you're really serious about your business, like next level leadership, all in. Get access to NLS University, that thing. There's one course in NLS University with the all-in package that changed our business.
Yep.
Changed our business. So when people ask us, like, how'd you guys grow so fast? You went from zero in your network, like literally had never done an online business to where we're at today in
9 months.
9 months. We seized every opportunity, including all in.
Massive imperfect action.
And treating
made a whole bunch of mistakes, honestly.
Oh yeah.
Our coach Daniel Kump helped us every step of the way.
And treated every crumb like a feast.
Every come is a feast.
Oh, boy. Including these webinars. So when people were like, do you have questions? We were like, yeah, we do.
Well, how much time you got?
Yeah, exactly. So, all right, guys, we're 3 minutes over and it's Monday night. So we're going to go just hang out and enjoy the rest of our evening. We hope that you guys enjoyed tonight. Sorry, I'm like yelling. I'm super excited about all of this. Guys, we are so excited for you and just for, honestly, the end of the year. It's going to be a great end of the year, but don't wait. Don't be one of those people that wait for January 1 to be like, I'm turning over a new leaf.
If you wait till January 1, I won't believe you anyway.
You're never going to do it. Do it today. Make the decision today. So, guys, we love you. We believe in all of you. We're excited. I'm excited for Now Lifestyle in 2019. It's going to be a great year.
It's going to be as good a year as you make it. That's the fact.
Our friend Caesar.
Hey.
Man, I miss you. He was a good dude. All right. Anything else?
That's all I got.
We're getting out of here, guys. Have a great week. See you tomorrow night with Daniel Kump. I don't know who he's interviewing, but it's going to be awesome. And we'll see you later. Bye.
Cool, guys. Take care.